Hey guys, and welcome back to I'm Digital Hustler TV. Today I'll be doing a styling video for you guys. I've done many installation to styling videos for you from start to finish, but today I just wanted to show you this new style that I will be doing today. And today's hair is provided by Wiggins Hair. This wig is their 24 inch body wave 13 by 4 lace frontal wig, and it has full parting space from ear to ear, like if you have a frontal and bundles, and of course there is, you know, little tracks in the back or whatever. But as you can see, we are starting this tutorial by me cutting off the extra lace. I already went ahead and, you know, did all of my layers, did all of my prepping, and you know, attached the wig. So now I'm just going to start from right here and just, you know, cut the extra lace and get into the whole styling part. So of course, you guys know I use my Beautiful Hustler lace adhesive, and I went ahead, you know, laid the wig down, did everything I did, you know, put my melt belt on there, and now I'm just going in with the eyebrow razor and cutting off the extra lace. Now if you've seen from the thumbnail, you see this is a like a top ponytail with a roller set kind of look. So this was my first time doing this look, and I will do it again, but you know, with layers the second time around. But for today, I did not cut any of the hair. I just curled it and just let it go with the flow. But before we get into that whole section here, that section, you know, of that tutorial, I'm just gonna go ahead and finish raising off that lace and tacking everything down and pulling the section that I will have for the baby hair out. Natural. This wig did come pre-plucked, but I did go in and do even more plucking because I really wanted a very natural hairline. And plus, this style that she is wearing is only temporary because we are going to restyle it this weekend for you know, my god sister's birthday bash, where she is doing like a remake of prom. So she's going to end up having a pinup this weekend, and I probably won't be able to have time to do a tutorial on the pinup style, but I would definitely post it, and you know, I will eventually do a tutorial on like some prom hairstyles and stuff like that. So however, like I mentioned, this wig did come pre-plucked, so I just, you know, wanted a super natural hairline, especially because for the style we'll be doing after this, it will require it to be like, you know, laid, of course. But once I get all this baby hair and lace pulled out and separated, I will go ahead and begin to style the wig. And you know, it's a very pretty simple style. Yeah, it's very simple. It's just, you know, I didn't want to go baby hair crazy either, because I know I was going to restyle it, and this just wasn't, you know, a permanent style. So I didn't do too much. Well, I didn't barely do anything as far as like the baby hair and stuff like that. I only just did the two that I have, you know, pulled down right there in the front, and then the rest, I just, you know, it was nothing else after that. But now I'm gonna go ahead and part a section off from ear to ear. You know, make sure you leave some hair to cover the tracks in the back. So I did leave hair for that, but I am gonna go ahead and, you know, part it ear to ear. I'm going to ponytail the top section out the way and start by working with the back. And for the back, all I'm going to do is just, you know, of course, press that part around the, you know, around the tracks to make sure it's flat. And I'm, you know, once I hot comb that out, I will go ahead and curl and then pin the curls in the back. So you guys will see more of that right about now. back section and split it into two so I can have two equal sides. And then I'm going to take that one section on the right side and split that into two. And I will do the same thing for the other side. So in total, it will be four sections. And I'm just going to take some Fantasia's heat protectant and spread it on the hair. And then go on with my golden hot hot curling tool on 500 degrees. And I'm just going to add three big curls and pin them in each one of those sections. So total, it will be 12 pin curls in the back. I'll do three for every section that I have separated. And I just take that, duct clip and I just clip it and, you know, let it sit on there until I have everything curled up. So pretty much I'm going to curl, like I said, you know, big sections, three in each row, and then I will go ahead and style up the top. And right here, I'm just showing you what it looks like, and I'm just letting you know that I'm going to curl that side the opposite direction. You want the curls to come towards each other, so you will see how I have it there. And now that I have that all curled up, coming towards each other, I'm going to go ahead and get the top part, ponytailed and curled as well. So I'm just going to use my wax stick and my hot comb to just sleek the ponytail. I did not want to add too much product or holding spray because, as I mentioned, this is just a style for right now. In literally 2 days, it will be a whole different style for the prom birthday bash that we are redoing. So stay tuned for that. And if I do have time, I might kind of like vlog the process of me and my sisters and my god sisters and, her friends, all of us redoing prom, because y'all know back then when you look at your old prom pictures, we all looked a mess. So now that it's 2020 and we all can afford to get what we desire and buy what we want and wear what we want and, everything like that, it should be a very, very fun experience. So stay tuned for that, guys. I think it's going to be super fun and super lit. But, I went ahead and took that Tresemme holding spray and I did spray it across the hairline because I'm going to tie that down with the elastic band as I style the ponytail. Now, it's very important when you do ponytail looks that you do not pull the hair into the ponytail too tight, because you can't ripple your lace by it being pulled too tight. It can ripple, which I did not have this issue, that issue in this install, but that is a key point when doing ponytails. And this is something new I tried right here. After spraying that Tresemme, I took the hot comb and hot combed the roots with the Tresemme on it. That was something I've never done before. And I really love how that came out because it really sleek those edges down with a nice firm hold. So I really did like that idea. But now, as I mentioned, I did not want to use too much product as far as like holding spray to spritz the ponytail down. So I'm just using my wax stick and I use the comb and just smoothed everything up. And I'm just taking a big black rubber band and just securing that top ponytail part. So now that I have that, I'm just going to go ahead and take just a little holding spray in the comb and just smooth everything right on in, just a little bit, not too much. I don't want to get carried away, and this is what it's looking like. So now I'm gonna take a little piece of that ponytail and wrap it around that rubber band so it's more of a seamless ponytail type of look. And you just want to hold add spritz the holding spray and just spray it and wrap it, and then once you get it all the way wrapped, of course dry it and make sure it's secured. And then I would just split that ponytail into two, curl it and pin it down. man, this looks super cute pinned up. And you, and this is, if you have a prom in like real life and you don't want your crust to drop, I advise that if you was to get a style like this, to have your stylist just keep the pins in, and on the day of prom, you can just take it down, and it's nothing to just rub your hands through the curls and, you know, just get it flowing. But however, I went ahead and, you know, removed that melt belt, and yes, I'm cleaning off that extra holding spray, you know, from around the hairline. This doesn't always happen, but if it does, you know, just go ahead and clean it off, and I'll end up cleaning it up some more, you know, towards the end of the video. But I'm just plucking a little bit of those hairs out, and I just went ahead and just cut the baby hair, and I just did the baby hair off camera because it's just two simple little swoops. And now I'm back, and I just left the sides down. I did not want to do no like sideburn baby hair, because when I restyle it, I don't know how I'm going to want to do the baby hair for that look. But now I'm just going to go ahead and remove all of those pins. And y'all, this is going to look so freaking pretty when I pull the curls to the front. Like I said, this is a very cute, simple look. This is actually like a really nice prom look as well. But you know, we just wanted this for right now, but for the prom, she's actually going to do that pinup style, so you guys will see that on my timeline, and I will also post it in my YouTube community. But this is what it looks like when you you know, let everything go, you release those curls. And if you didn't notice, we started off this tutorial with two lashes, and she took one off in the middle of the process, but at the end result video, we will put that lash back on, because this is looking real cockeyed right now. But this is what the hair looks like, and you can also be a little versatile with this. You can wear the ponytail to the side if you don't want to bust it down the middle and wear it like that. You can wear it to this side and curl it to match the flow of, you know, the direction the hair is going. Or you can also flip it over to the other side as well. It's just really your preference on how you want the look to go. You can kind of play with the bang to give it, the ponytail to give it that bang look on the side, like how I did here. Or you can also bust it down the middle, like I said, or flip it to the other side. But this is the finishing results. I hope you guys enjoyed this styling video. Thank you guys for tuning in, and see you guys next time.